First one is just a lot of training. It's simple. It's just a lot of training. The second is I think the pleasure. Well, they are related, but it's true. Just the pleasure to. Maybe I sound a bit crazy, but you know, the pleasure to feel pain, the pleasure to. The third thing is to achieve some things. You know, every time, you know, I say to you that I want to progress, you know, so I just push myself, you know, to achieve this point, who show me that every time I progress. Yesterday I could do that, and today I could do one more. And the other point, it's honesty. Honesty, the fact to be honest with myself. The fact to be honest with myself is just because I've been doing sports since I'm 5 years old. Now I'm 34. And it just, I feel honest because it's the way I am. So this is one of the big things. And the other element, smile. Yeah, the other element is the smile, because every time I train, you know, when I achieve something, when I, just the fact that I push myself, you know, to go to train, make me smile inside. You don't see necessarily, but inside, you know, I just feel happy. I just feel cool. And when I manage to achieve something, even sometimes it's hard, you know, because I set up some goal and I'm tired, or it looks very far away, but you know, I finish the session and I'm smiling inside. So I think that for all these reasons, yeah, keep doing it. I've seen the documentary about Dinkins, and I really like it. I really like it because he's very... He's quite inspiring. He's quite inspiring because he has a nice energy, because he has, you know, something, you know, you can see that. And I was talking with him, but he explained to me that, you know, somehow, this documentary, it was during a period of 1 year. So this is, you know, is the things you have to do careful somehow with the video, because I really like the documentary. I really like, you know, what you see on the video. But with a video, you don't have necessarily the behind the scene. You don't have necessarily, because he explained to me, you know, for us, you know, for example, I've done this jump, and it took me, you know, 1 year to be able to reach this this goal, because every time I went through it, you know, I couldn't do it. But the shame, it's a you can't see only the result. If I didn't talk to him, I wouldn't understand necessarily that, I would understand because I know a bit, but what kind of effort did he do to make it happen? What is like be director of Parkour Generation? It's good. Now it's but first of all, we, you know, with Stefan and Dan, we decided 1.5 years ago to set up a company. So what we've done, we set up a private company we call Parkour Generation. We've been in touch with an accountant, you know, who had some clue about set up company. So he really helped us for that. I think it was the biggest steps. Afterwards, you know, he was really in charge of administration stuff. We were just with Dan and Stefan, but we try to do our best to run the company, to be physically active, to do the performance, to take care of all the administration stuff. and it takes quite a long time, so it's quite tiring. Sometimes it could be very demanding, you know, physically, psychologically. Try to find good solutions, try to you know, to be most of the time agree on the decision. My role, the same that the others, but for myself, it's I'm teaching, I'm doing performance, and I run, you know, the Parkour Generations, you know, in the way that we try to organize, for example, when we need more teachers somewhere, we try to organize, you know, workshop, we try to organize different, but when we go to seminar, you know, we have to organize all the travel and everything. So yeah, I think it's most of our duties. Try to have a good communication with our partner, you know, some of the founders, guys like Chao, William, Laurent, Yann, you know, we try to be the most professional, but sometimes I have to say that it's not the easiest. Voilà. First of all, I think is it becomes from my gene. No, my father has a big voice, so I think that naturally I have a big voice because it comes from my father. And another point, when I was younger, I was goalkeeper. I was goalkeeper, and I remember that the coach, he said to me, you know, Forrest, I want to hear you on the field, you know. So, so he said, you know, you are the leader of your team, I want to hear you, your defender has to hear you. I say, okay. And I just work in the way that I can make my voice louder without make stress on my throat. The thing is just, I don't know if I can explain, but I just block, you know, the this area. Oh, we make that is straight away louder. So I think that for these reasons, yeah, my voice is a bit hard sometimes.